What's going on, guys? Andy here, Cut and Clean Lawn Care. I'm with Rob, the owner, and I'm gonna call him owner-operator because he's hands-on, man.
Yep.
Here at Mocan Power Equipment in Spring Hill, which is where I bought my mower, as you guys know. And they also got Toro now, guys. And you guys know how I feel about the multi-force from testing at GAE. But I'm up here today. Had some rain this morning. I got the day off. I'm mowing hard Friday. Got some stuff going on this weekend. So I wanted to swing by because I was having issues leveling the deck myself. Obviously, I'm not the most mechanically inclined person in the world, as you guys know too. So he offered me to come down. Said, I'll show you how to do it. We'll go through it. We'll look at it. I'll show you some stuff that some of these mowers not necessarily have wrong with it. They're bad mowers. Every mower has its pros and cons, but just kind of things to look for, guys. So let's go check that out. So guys, we're back here with my mower. I'm gonna switch around a second, let him kind of talk about some of the stuff to look for. Obviously, like I said, I was having a hard time adjusting it myself. Every time I got it leveled, because I had it up on blocks, is the way I was doing it.
Yep.
Kind of the way I saw videos on YouTube. This is YouTube's fault, by the way. It's not my fault, it's YouTube's fault. How people were doing it. And every time I'd get it leveled where I wanted it, everything was hung right, all matched up. I took the blocks off, it was out of whack again. Every single time. So I'll let him kind of go through and talk about some of the stuff that he does and he knows to look for, obviously. So it might be able to help you guys out if you have one of these Gravely mowers and you're getting the same situation. So let's check it out, man.
Yep. Okay, so if one of the first things you probably want to do is buy one of these. They're real inexpensive. This is a blade or the deck leveler. It basically just the tip of the blade goes right down on there and you can see on the gauge to get it set up right. Now, the other thing that I do is I always set the deck at 3.5 inches. Once you get it set at 3.5 inches, what you also want to do is make sure your tire pressures are correct. So like in Andy's case, we did both back tires at 13.5. The front tires are the semi-pneumatics, but you know, so you don't need to have to check the tire pressure on those. The next thing, once you get that done, is you want to angle your blade out straight with the edge of the deck. Once you get it, the blade edge of the deck, you'll set it right on the tip of the gauge. And once you get that set, you'll go to the other side and you'll see how far off or if you're level. But once you get that figured out, if you're say 1/4 inch on one side, then you'll loosen up your bolts and we can show you how to do that to get it set correctly. The next thing after you get your side to side level, you'll want to level your pitch. All these mowers, you want to get great suction for the grass to be able to suck the grass up and get it cut. With these mowers, you want to have no more than 1/2 inch pitch. And when I say 1/2 inch pitch, you want the back of the deck up no more than 1/2 inch than the front of the deck. And so you're kind of angled at a slight angle. That'll get you your best cut. Sometimes if you do angle them too much, you'll lose all your cut. It basically just the grass kind of shakes around underneath the deck. So
what about flat? Like some people say when you're leveling a deck, some manufacturers talk about you want the deck to be flat.
Right.
Now to me, that seems like it would also kind of have the same counter effect. It would end up kind of wanting to fan out too much and maybe push the grass down.
Right. Now if you do your decks flat, it's for different types of grass.
Okay.
So if you have like a real thick azoysia grass that's already, I mean, you're not going to get any kind of movement out of the grass. You want to level it flat so that way it's just cutting it straight clean. And the whole deck is creating the suction.
Okay.
So, and the best tool to also is the level floor. That's where you got to start with it also. If you don't have a level floor, I mean, you're going to have to find something that is level enough. Most of the folks that do the 4x4 blocks under each side of the deck, that's if you don't have a level floor. It really helps because you're stretching out your length over you're stretching out your surface area over a larger length. So, okay, so for setting up on how to adjust these old, what we call the old ACI decks for the Gravelys, our older stand-on decks, it's really simple. They made it real simple for anybody to be able to adjust these. It's just doing it the first time to get it correct. Once you've done it or seen it done, it makes it a lot easier and makes more sense. So what you start out doing on all four corners is you loosen, there's a nut on the inside and a nut on the outside of the actual hanger. And then so forth on all four corners, you loosen those outer nuts that hold it on there. Underneath each turnbuckle bolt, there's a nut that captures each one of those. What that does is that locks the deck down to keep it from becoming unadjusted. So basically, you'll loosen the bolts underneath. You will, after you have all of the turnbuckle hanger bolts loose, you'll loosen the nut underneath the turnbuckle bolt, and then according to if you're going to raise it or lower it, you just turn each turnbuckle. I recommend that you do it maybe one turn or two turns per side. So you'll do two turns on this one, two turns on that one, check your levelness. And then until you get it to the same as the other side, and then vice versa. And then once you get it all adjusted, the first thing that I always tighten down is the capture nut underneath the turnbuckle, because that keeps it from moving up and down anymore. And then you'll just go back and you'll really want to crank these down. You don't want to just get a good hand tight. You want to get a good physical crank on it. That way it's nice and tight and it won't vibrate or shake loose.
Now, for those of you guys that follow my Instagram and my Snapchat stuff, you know how big of a time I had with this. I had properties to mow. I couldn't get this thing to turn over and start. I was going through all my safety switches, every fuse I could find in the manual, except for one. And after talking to Rob about it, it's kind of a common problem on these and what you would consider probably a design flaw, which is gonna happen with every mower. It doesn't matter what mower you buy, everything's got a little kink in it. You know, that's just the design. So we're gonna go over that real quick and kind of talk about this real quick.
All right, so when you called me up, the first thing that you said or that I asked you was—
I said, Rob, please God, call me back.
Yeah, please call me back. And so once I finally called you back, the first question I had was your light on, the little red light on the dash? That is a pretty good indication that the system, if that red light on the dash is on, it's a good indication that the system is good and functioning.
Okay.
If the red light is off, that means we have a break in the system. And so—
Now let's say this real quick.
Okay.
Say you go to turn the key on, the light turns on red, and it's not starting.
Right.
Would you say it could be something as simple as like the safety switches and stuff like that? Because the system would still show up fine, right?
Yep. So if the red light's on, generally it's either a battery issue or a safety switch issue.
Okay.
The next thing that I asked you was, did it just click over or did it crank? Nope, didn't have any of that.
It's not doing anything.
And so once I knew that we didn't have the red light, I knew to go to that fuse.
Okay.
It's not a fuse that is in your manual.
Right.
But for some reason, on a lot of these older stand-ons, they had the issue where the fuse will actually corrode up inside.
Yeah.
And that's what happened to you. So
yeah, it was just full of like white powder, no connection.
Yep.
So just a simple fix can be that stressful, because I'm talking at least 5 hours.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Tinkering with stuff.
And it, I had to chase it around, like I told you, for a good month. You know,
because he had the same problem. One right out of the crate,
Fresh out of the crate.
It just gets water buildup in that. So like I was telling him, like when I pulled that fuse, got a new one in, I used dielectric grease, a little grease on it, made sure the connection was tight, not gonna have the problem. Same stuff I use on my trailer for like, you know, your light board for, you know, hooking up your trailer lights and stuff like that. So yeah, guys, that's a little bit of talking, just like, kind of like some shop talk, talking about the Gravely Pro Stance. This is a 2013. And some of these will go as general knowledge for any mower. Obviously the adjusting the height's gonna be different, whether you're on chains or, you know, even fixed deck, stuff like that. It's gonna be, you know, a little totally different process, but the same general idea of flat ground, what to use to check it, stuff like that. And also common issues and things to check, like if your light's not on, you're not getting any electric, check for things like that fuse. If the light is on, safety switches, things like that. So if you are having that problem, go through some of these steps, guys, because I know I was having a nightmare with it. But thankfully, like Rob, having a dealer like him who called me on his day off to tell me what the problem was wrong, you're not gonna get that through most dealers. So I'm really glad Rob was able to do that for me. So if you guys are having the problem, just kind of go through this checklist, check your manual out for sure, and see if you can't figure out the problem, man. Like always, guys, like, comment, subscribe. Make sure you guys check out MoCan and Spring Hill if you're ever in the area. Great group of guys out here, man, for sure. So
thanks.
We'll see you in the next one, man.